Hello guys, welcome to my channel. So I got asked which is the best programming language, and it's like asking which tool do you need to build a house. You can't really answer that. First, you need to think of what you want to build. If you want to build mobile apps, you first choose if you want them to be native or hybrid. Native is you have each code for each platform, iOS and Android, and the hybrid are apps are the ones that you use one code base for both iOS and Android. There are lots of pros and cons for each side, so I won't really get into that. But if you want, let's say, native iOS application, you use Swift or Objective-C. If you want native Android application, you use Java or Kotlin, mostly Kotlin these days. If you want to build a website, you choose, of course, JavaScript. If you want to learn machine learning, you either choose Python or R or MATLAB. There are plenty of options there. And if you want to build a video game on a game engine, you either choose C# or C++. So it's really important for you to first think of what you want to build, and then you go and pick the appropriate language. And the number one language, in my opinion, is JavaScript, because you can do the front end with React, you can do back end with Node.js, and you can do desktop applications with Electron.js, and you can do machine learning as well, but I don't really remember the framework. And if you try JavaScript and you don't really like it, you can go with Python. You can use it for websites, you can use it for machine learning. It's a great language and it's really popular. So now let's say that you learn JavaScript and then you build a website and then you regret it. You don't really like building websites, and then you go to building mobile games or video games. So let's say you learn C++. You won't start from nothing again, because you already know what a function is, what an if statement is, from the JavaScript, because you already learned JavaScript. So the transition won't be that difficult for you, because you already learned something from another language. So don't be afraid of picking a language. You have the luxury of freedom to try different things, so don't be afraid on that. I learned HTML and CSS because I wanted to build a website. Then I learned JavaScript because I really wanted to make the website work, and then I wanted to build a web scraper, so I learned Python. And after that, I wanted to build a video game, so I learned C# in order to use it with the Unity game engine. And after that, I tried the iOS platform. I really enjoyed the whole UI UX thing, and I learned Swift in order to make an application for the iOS devices. And after that, I was really intrigued by the whole idea of the backend, and I learned Node.js. It wasn't that difficult for me to learn it because I already knew JavaScript. And after that, I learned TypeScript because it's a superset of JavaScript and it's way more robust than JavaScript. And after that, I learned React, because right now I'm a front-end developer. So it wasn't that difficult for me to learn React because I already knew JavaScript and TypeScript. So my point is, do not be afraid of picking a language. So this was the video. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.